In this example, we're going to look at a tenuous stirred tank reactor that's run isothermally by having heat exchange, first order reaction. We're given a feed temperature, and then the reactor is at a higher temperature because it's an exothermic reaction. And then we have a coolant jacket around the CSTR that flows cooling water at 40 degrees C. And for sake of simplicity, we'll assume the flow rate of that water is high enough that essentially the water inlet and the outlet is 40 degrees C. That's just an approximation to demonstrate the concept here. And so we have two questions. What's the size of the reactor in order to get 90% conversion at this temperature? And then what heat transfer coefficient will we need if the heat transfer area for this tank and the surrounding jacket is 6.13 square meters? So we're given heat of reaction. The heat capacities for A and B are the same, which means the heat of reaction does not change with temperature. The rate constant at 170 degrees C, the inlet volumetric flow rate, and the inlet concentration of 3,000 moles per cubic meter. So the first thing we do on this type problem is to draw a diagram that represents the process and put in what we know about the process. So I've represented the jacket around the CSTR, conversion 90%, so fraction conversion 0.9. FA0 is the molar flow rate, which is the volumetric flow rate times the concentration, and this is the 600 moles per hour. What we want to do now is apply mass balances to this problem, and the mass balance we're going to apply is for component A. We have A flowing in, A flowing out. They differ because we have some reactions. This is rate of reaction per volume times the volume of the liquid in the reactor. And since we're at steady state, this is equal to zero. So what we want to do now is substitute in the values. The molar flow rate in, we know the molar flow rate out. For converting 90%, then we have 10% unreacted. So this is 1/10 of FA0. And it's a first order reaction. So the important thing to remember about a CSTR is that this should be the final concentration. In other words, this is the exit concentration of A. Because we have a liquid phase system, the volumetric flow rate we assume is approximately the same. And so the exit molar flow rate is 1/10 of the inlet, which means the concentration CA final is 1/10 of the inlet concentration. So now we can substitute numbers. FA0 minus 1/10 means 9/10 of FA0, and we calculated that FA0 is 600 moles per hour. The rate constant, which is given above, and then the reactor concentration is 1/10 of CA0, and then the reactor volume is what we're trying to determine. So the only unknown here is volume, and we look at units of volume is going to end up being in cubic meters. We get 2.3 cubic meters for the volume. So that's the first part. The second part now is to determine what heat transfer coefficient we need, which means we need to do an energy balance on the reactor. So there are various ways we can write down the energy balance. Let's look at it from the physical viewpoint. They were feeding a cold liquid that we have to heat up to reactor temperature. That's this term, the molar flow rate times the molar heat capacity times the temperature difference between the reactor temperature and the inlet temperature. The reason we raise the temperature is because we have a heat reaction, and then we have so many moles reacting per time. And the reactor would be hotter than 170 degrees, but we remove some heat by heat transfer. So we're expecting this term Q dot to be negative. So we have the numbers to substitute in. We know this is 600 moles per hour, and the heat capacity is in kcals per mole per change in Kelvin. So we can write the change in centigrade, because change in centigrade is the same as a change in Kelvin. This is equal to then the heat of reaction, and then the molar flow rate leaving, we react at 90%, so 60 Q dot, the heat transfer, is a heat transfer coefficient, an area for heat transfer, and then the coolant temperature minus reactor temperature. This is going to be a negative term because the coolant temperature is well below the reactor temperature. If we do the calculations and check the units, we can see that the heat transfer coefficient that we would need, degrees C or degrees H, since it's a change, 3.4 kcals per square meter per degree C per hour. And this is the heat transfer coefficient to maintain it, reactor isothermally at 170 degrees.